Hello friends, in this video we are going to see about the National Nutrition Mission. Poshan Abhiyaan or the National Nutrition Mission is a flagship program of the Ministry of Women and Child Development. The Government of India approved this particular mission on 1st December 2017. The goals of the National Nutrition Mission are to achieve improvement in nutritional status of the children from age 0 to 6 years, adolescent girls, pregnant women and lactating mothers. The ministries involved in this particular mission are the Ministry of Women and Child Development, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation. When there are quite a few programs to tackle malnutrition, why this particular mission? As per the Global Hunger Index, the children of age 0 to 6 years are found to be 14.5% are undernutritioned, 21% were underwasting, and 38% were having stunting, and the mortality rate is around 4.8%. As per the 4th National Family Health Survey, 69% of the children are aged between 6 to 59 months had anemia, and 38.4% had stunting. So to concentrate on this particular age category, this particular mission has been put forth. So now we see the approach of this particular mission. It doesn't work on a solo mode, and it ensures a robust convergence system with various programs that addresses malnutrition, such as Anganwadi services, Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana, Scheme for Adolescent Girls, that is SAG, started by the Janani Suraksha Yojana, National Health Mission, and the Public Distribution System. One of the main criteria, or to say the characteristics of this particular National Nutrition Mission, is that it's going to have an ICT-based real-time monitoring system, and it will be incentivizing states and unitary territories for meeting the targets. It will also incentivize the Anganwadi workers for using IT-based tools and eliminating the old-scale registers, the book registers. Social audits and measurement of height in children at the Anganwadi centers will be conducted regularly and will be mapped into the ICT, as well as setting up of nutrition resource centers will be taken in a fast-paced manner, and bringing the masses to that particular national resource centers will be done via the Jan Andolan. Let's see what are the targets in this particular mission. The mission will be rolled out in three phases. One phase has already been over, that is from 2017 to 18, 18 to 19 and 19 to 20 are the other two phases. And the targets were reduction in stunting by 2%, reduction in undernutrition by 2%, reduction in anemia by 3%, and reduction in the low birth weight by 2%. And stunting will be one of the major issue that will be tackled in this particular mission, and this will run on full pedal in reducing stunting so as to reduce the total number from 38.4 to 25% by 2022. So let's see what are the benefits this mission has, so that it functions in a better way to reduce the malnutrition. So it has a real-time monitoring. So by using the real-time monitoring supported by the ICT facilities, will provide a better efficacy as well as an efficiency in the data collected. Social audits and nutrition resource centers will enhance the delivery of the resources, as well as will hold accountability of the complete approach of this particular mission. Now let's see the challenges that this mission has to face. Technical competency of the workers involved in the National Nutrition Mission and the respective convergence program. As we have already seen that this program is not a solo mode, it is a convergence of various programs that tackles malnutrition. So Anganwadi, as well as the Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana, as well as the Janani Suraksha Yojana, the workers in these particular programs has to have a good knowledge about the IT, whereas or they have to be trained on the technical competency in using those IT tools. So that's going to be a big challenge. as well as providing infrastructure and maintenance. In having a real-time monitoring system in remote areas will be one of the major challenge. And another one is the protection of the data that has been collected. And there has to be a coordination between the ministries involved. Since there are three ministries involved in this particular mission, the coordination will pose one of the major challenges that to be noted. So with this, we finish with the National Nutrition Mission. Thank you very much for listening.